Our subject is and has been the race of the faith. The race of the faith. It is the race because there are many races, but this is a particular unique race. Particular unique race, and it is particular and unique to every individual. That your race is not my race. Hallelujah. But it is also the faith, because there are many faiths. The Bible says faith comes by hearing, and you can only receive the faith of what you have heard. If what you had was witchcraft, the possibility is you shall receive its faith. Praise the Lord. So it is the race of the faith. Okay, let's read this scripture. Tutome ili andiko pamoja. Where is it? You took it away again, my sister. Okay, we can read it from the analog version. Let's read together. And what? Everyone who competes, is temperate in all. Now they do it to obtain what? Can you read together if somebody went to school? To obtain? But we for an imperishable, also called an incorruptible. Praise the Lord. Little history is that there was Isthmian games. These games were conducted in Corinth, and they competed because of perishable crowns. These were crowns made of olive. So Paul is trying to compare their race and the race that we are running. Then he says that their race, they will receive perishable crowns, that is corruptible, but we shall receive imperishable crowns. Hallelujah. The crowns we receive will give us access to eternal life. Also, will give us an opportunity to reign with Christ. Paul explains that in Timothy, 2 Timothy 2:12. It will give us an opportunity to reign with Christ. Therefore, it's very important to understand how we should run this race. Now, get me that scripture, I think the next verse, which talks about you therefore must run in this way. That there is a way we must run. Can you read that next verse? Give me for Corinthians. Therefore I run thus. Give me another version. Not with uncertainty. Thus I fight, not as one who beats the air. That is the next one. Therefore, run this way. Hallelujah. So, which way are we expected to run? And we saw that in Hebrews chapter number 12. Last Sunday we were talking about the seven weights that we have. But in chapter number 12, the Bible talks about a cloud of witnesses. Hawa ni watu wanakaa mashabiki. Unapokimbia wanakaa kupigia makofi. But what the writer of Hebrews is trying to bring about has nothing to do with spectators. He's talking about something different that we would like to look at today. That these witnesses are portraying testimonies. Hallelujah. They are bringing about pathways. They are bringing a pattern. They are saying, if you must win this race of faith, you need to run like this. Hallelujah. That version says, run in such a way. Get me that one. Run in such a way. So, there is a way that we must run this race. And one of the ways we must run this way, we must put aside all the baggages. Hatuwezi kukimbia na mizigo. Sema amina. Sema amina. Hatuwezi kimbia na mizigo na tukaona mizigo saba ambazo lazima tuweke kando. Anasema tena hatuwezi kukimbia na dhambi. Sin that easily entangles us. This kind of sin is not a particular sin to everyone, but everyone has a particular weakness. Vile tumeketi hapa, kila mmoja wetu ana udhaifu. He's saying if we must run this race, we must put that weakness aside. We cannot tolerate it in this race. And now he goes on to talk about witnesses. This includes Abraham, includes Isaac, Jacob, includes Sarah, includes some of the women in the Bible that you will never think they are faith. They are all found in the book of Hebrews chapter number 11. And he mentions them many as you can read. Then he says, they are all watching us. Therefore, he's referring to these witnesses and saying, they are men and women who showed and paved the path. And if we must run, win, we must look and to them. Hallelujah. Can you say again in the name of Jesus? Can you shout it loud in the name of Jesus? Oh my God, say in the name of Jesus, I choose to run my race. It says, we are looking at their testimonies. We are looking at their references. They are showing us authorized pathways in which we need to run this way. They are showing us predefined formulas. If we must win this race, there are people that have already gone ahead and we cannot assume them. We're asking ourselves, how did Abraham stay without a child for all this long and he managed to stand? We are asking ourselves, how did Gideon with 300 men win the battle against multitudes? And we are saying, even with what I have now, I can be able to climb the mountain. Hallelujah. That I'm able to run the race. I'm not going to sit back and fold my hands. Nianze kusema sina mtu wa kunisaidia. Ninaweza kukimbia. Hallelujah. So they gave us patterns on how we need to run this race and finally win. Now let me show you four things that you need to do first of all if we must run this race. There are four encounters. I had a man of God talk about them and I was so touched. Four encounters which are very, very important if you will win any race. I'm talking to people who are battling some things in their lives and I'm telling you, if we apply these formulas, kuna watu walishinda hata wewe utashinda. Amen. Mara nyingi shetani anapenda kuchekelea watoto wa Mungu na kuonyesha jinsi hawawezi. Leo tunasimama kwa imani na tunatangaza hakuna mlima wowote ambao utatushinda kupanda. Ninaweza kufanya mambo yote kwa yeye anayenipa nguvu. Hata kama kuna kitu ambacho kinakula watu wa kwenu, wewe hakitakukula kwa sababu uko katika imani. Hallelujah. Kwa sababu uko katika imani. Hata kama kuna uchawi ambao wanaroga watu wa kwenu, wewe hautarogwa. Watoto wako watarogwa. Kazi yako haitarogwa. Biashara yako haitarogwa. Bwana atakufanya usimame imara katika jina la Yesu. There is a race I must run. There are victories to be won. Number one, encounter. Hallelujah. You must encounter Jesus Christ. We have so many people in a church like this ambao hajaokoka lakini wanakaa kanisani. Hata wengine wana lugha nzuri, Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Lakini hawajakutana na Yesu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hatutaki kukaa hapa kama members club. Ati baada ya kumaliza ibada tunasalimiana tunaenda nyumbani. Lazima uwe umeokoka. Kama kuna mtu hapa haujakiri dhambi, leo ni siku ya wokovu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Na usiniambie malaika nitokezea nikajikuta nimeokoka. There is a pattern that has been set in the Bible. I must be able to hear that I confess with my mouth and I believed in my heart. You must encounter Jesus. Can somebody shout Jesus?
Yes.
We cannot run this race like defeated people. No. We are a church of Jesus and we must conquer everything that comes against us. Ndio sababu wachawi wanaturoga tunarogeka. Tunasimama imara leo, tunatangaza hakuna uchawi utaonekana katika nyumba ya Yakobo katika jina la Yesu. When a man encounters Jesus, his life is changed. It is said in the Bible we are now new creation. Hallelujah. The old has passed. Hawezi kuwa kwa wokovu na bado wewe ni mlevi. Hawezi kuwa kwa wokovu wewe ni msherati. Hawezi kuwa kwa wokovu na wewe bado unaenda kwa wachawi. Hawezi kuwa kwa wokovu na umejichanganya. Umeokoka, umeokoka. Hallelujah. Hakuna njia nyingine. Kama uko hapa, haujarudia maombi ya wokovu, naomba usiende nyumbani maana leo tunakuombea. Ili ukimbie hii mbio ukiwa unajulikana. Hallelujah. Gari haina number plate, hiyo ni gari ya mwizi. Lazima uwe na number plate. Number plate yetu ni Jesus. When Paul encountered Jesus on his way to where? Damascus. It was very clear. For the Bible says the light of God hit him. Hallelujah. And he fell down. Look at this mighty man called Paul. The one who is persecuting the church of Jesus. He came down. Brothers and sisters, we have to come down. Amen.
Amen.
When this light hits you properly, hakuna mwili tena, unarudi chini. Unakuwa servant of God. Ikikupiga vizuri. And the Bible says, while down there, he heard a voice, Paul, Paul, why are you, Saul, why are you persecuting me? And the scripture says, he answered and said, Lord. Can you say Lord? Now, Lord means honor. We must know that he's the honor of our lives. He's the honor of our families. He's the honor of our finances. He's the honor. Everything we have belongs to God. And everything we have should glorify God. Siwezi kuwa na nguvu ya kwenda kusema ya kwenda kushangilia mpira. Na kuja kanisani siwezi kushangilia hallelujah. Now, if you have a mouth, can you shout hallelujah? Shout a bigger hallelujah! Huwezi shangilia vitu vya ulimwengu. Kwa siasa wewe ni number one. Lakini ukija kanisani unasikia kuboeka. Unasikia kama umewekelea mizigo. Hapana. Vitu vya Mungu tutavifurahia. Hallelujah. Hata tukisema tunaenda kujenga kanisa tunafurahia. Like now we have now launched a witnessing team. Unaweza join. Every Thursday. We have located 6 places. Kama hatuko hapa, tutakuwa Githurai. Kama next Thursday, tutakuwa Githurai. Kama hatuko Githurai, tutakuwa Zimmerman. Nasima kanisa yetu. Bana siwe sana. Kama hatuko Zimmerman, tutakuwa Spring Valley. Kama hatuko Spring Valley, tutakuwa Umoja One. Alafu sasa kama hatuko pale, tutakuwa either hapa Tena, ama tutakuwa Mala, ama tutakuwa Githurai. For now.
Praise the Lord.
Every Thursday, tunatembea tukiambia watu nuru ya Yesu. Kuna mtu hapa alitembelewa Thursday. Naomba uinue mkono. Kama uko hapo alitembelewa Thursday. Asante ndugu yangu. Asante sana. Any other person? I'm very proud of you. Any other person? See? Anasifia sana. Si unaona? Sasa huyo ndugu angepatikana wapi? Kuna mwingine alitembelewa Thursday. We visited many and they are still coming. Praise the Lord. Yeah. And that's the work we were given as the church of Jesus. Sio kiketi kwa vikundi na kuongea kuhusu watu. Kuongea kuhusu Yesu. Amen?
Amen.
Kuongea kuhusu nani?
Yes.
Encounter Jesus. Kwa sababu ya kuto encounter Jesus, ndio naona wengine wetu tabia zinakaza kishetani shetani. Lakini ukiencounter Jesus, na kuambia utakaa kama yeye. Utakaa kama yeye. You must encounter Jesus. Jesus so that you can run this race. Number two, you must encounter the Holy Spirit. Amen. We will talk those things in details. You must encounter the Holy Spirit, the person of the Holy Spirit. And when you encounter the Holy Spirit, it comes with blessings. Even Jesus. If you encounter Jesus, it comes with blessings. The first blessing it comes with is the blessings of forgiveness of sin. Na hiyo ni baraka kubwa. Wewe ulikuwa msherati, wengine walikuwa wameua, wengine walikuwa wameiba vitu za watu. Sasa Yesu anakuambia hizo vitu zote nimekusamehe. Hiyo ni baraka. Kuna watu hapa mngekuwa mmezikwa kama si Yesu. Ni baraka. Ukasamehewa dhambi. Praise the Lord. The second encounter that you receive is the nature of righteousness or the gift of righteousness. So you are not righteous because you fight. It's not self-righteousness. Mungu anakusaidia. You sail through. You sail through. And then the third gift you receive is what we call the Zoe life. That is eternal life. When you receive Jesus, wewe sasa umehakikishiwa utaishi milele. Hallelujah. Hata kama kuna kitu kingine ambacho ninapokea, hizo tatu zimetosha. And when we talk about the Zoe life, we are talking about John chapter 10 and verse number 10, which says the thief comes not but to do what? To steal. Hallelujah. To kill and to do what? And to destroy. You are only a thief if you are doing those three. If you are here and your work is to destroy, kila Mungu anajenga, unabomoa.
Wewe ni mwizi.
Praise the Lord. Because that is the assignment of a thief. But Jesus said, and the children of God look like Jesus. Jesus said, I have come. Hallelujah. That what? Oh my God, somebody knows the answer. That what? You may have what? Life eternal. Other versions talk about life abundantly. Abundant life means no poverty. Hallelujah. If you believe in poverty, too sorry. Because another preacher told me, hachanga kuambia watu, watakuwa tajiri. Kwa sababu watu wote hawezi kuwa tajiri. Yesu alisema maskini mtakuwa nao, true. Lakini mimi si mmoja wao. Kama wewe ni mmoja wao, asante. Mimi si mmoja wao. The poor people will always be there. But you who believes in God. You who believes in God. I said you who believes in God. He says, I will bless the works of your hand. Hata kama ulirogwa. Ndio sababu tumekuja kwa kisima hiki. Urogi ukaondolewe, uchawi ukaondolewe, magonjwa yakaondolewe, umaskini ukaondolewe. Tuko hapa kupokea uzima, uzima tele tele. Tuko kwa uzima. Praise the Lord. Utakuwaje mahali kuna kisima cha maji na bado una kiu? Amen. It is the pleasure of God. The Bible says, fear ye not, little flock, because it's my, the Father's good pleasure. To do what? To give you the kingdom. That's the pleasure of God. Now, if God gives you the kingdom, will you lack bread? No. And Jesus said, this bread is meant for the children. Children of God, can you shout amen?
Amen.
That's why I will preach against poverty with all passion. Whether you want to call it prosperity gospel, call it. But I will preach against it, especially to those who are going to run with me the race of faith. Because faith believes that all things are possible and a wall can be broken. Life can come where there is no life. We want to believe even in raising the dead. Do you believe that?
Yes.
Do you believe that?
Yes.
We believe even in raising the dead. Kama uko hapa wewe ni mgonjwa, usikubali kurudi nyumbani na magonjwa. You can't come to the house where there is healing and go back sick. Some of us believe in doctors than we believe in God. If you believe in God, we can pray and we will pray and you'll be set free. Number two is the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Time is going very fast. Number two, encounter the Holy Spirit. The Bible talks about the disciples of Jesus who met at the upper room and they were in one accord. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord came upon them. Hallelujah. And It says, like tongues, they sat on everyone that was in the house. Hakukua ni wakamba peke, ama ni waluya peke, ama ni wakikuyu peke. The Spirit of God, when he came and found them together. Hallelujah. Watoto wa Mungu sema hallelujah. We want to shame the devil. Kitu ya kukaliwa na mapepo tumekataa. Ya kuota kama tunafinyiliwa tumekataa. Ya kuota kama tunanyongwa tumekataa. Roho wa Bwana amekuja tukapate kuwa na uhuru katika jina la Yesu. Tangaza niko uhuru. It's the pleasure of God that you may be free. Every one of us that is in chains, believe God, chains must be broken. Hakuna minyororo ya shetani itasimama. Hallelujah. Believe God together with me. Hakuna minyororo utasimama. Wewe ambaye umefanya kazi haufanikiwi. Wewe ambaye haueni tasa. Hata tasa wa kupata pesa. Believe God today. By faith, all things are possible. Our God is well able. Hallelujah. I said our God is well able. Our God is well able. Tangaza na mimi Yesu anaweza. Yesu anaweza. Yesu anaweza. Hallelujah. And it comes by confessing. You must learn to speak with your mouth. Because a closed mouth is a closed destiny. Learn to speak with your mouth. You must encounter the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit also comes with many blessings. Among them is guidance. Hautatembea peke yako. Mtu atakushika mkono. Huyo mtu ni Roho Mtakatifu. Atakuongoza mahali pa kwenda. Atakuongoza mahali pa kuketi. Atakuongoza biashara ya kufanya. Atakuongoza mke wa kuoa. Hallelujah. Utashikwa mkono na Roho wa Bwana. Saa zingine atakupeleka mahali utaki kwenda, lakini ndio mahali pa baraka zako. Amen. Atakuongoza. That is one of the greatest blessings. The Spirit will lead you. Gari litakuja linataka kupita. Unasikia niingie kwa hii gari, niingie. Anakuambia hapana, usiingie hiyo gari. Usiingie hiyo gari. Usiingie hiyo gari. Hata naenda kuingia hivi najikwa mkono. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Gari linaenda. The next one which comes is much older. Unapanda hiyo. Unakuta ingine li roll, watu wote wamekufa. You be guided with the Holy Spirit. Which matatu to take, which one not to take? Utaingia kwa nyumba hivi, upewe glass, pengine atabiria mtu. Ukute, unapoipeleka kwa mdomo, glass inatetemeka, inatetemeka, inatetemeka mpaka, inaanguka chini. Kumbe ilikuwa na sumu. You'll be guided by the Spirit. Hallelujah. Na hakuna mtu aliongozwa na Roho Mtakatifu akapotea. You get lost because you guided yourself or you allowed men to guide you. But if you give yourself to the Lord and allow the Holy Spirit to guide you, you cannot get lost. He will guide you. He will be your helper. He will be your teacher. Many blessings that come with the Holy Spirit. He will clothe you. Hallelujah. He will even feed you. Don't be surprised. Nakutana na stranger na kuambia, the Lord has told me to give you these dollars. Unashangaa. Is it me? Look at, ni wewe. Mwingine mtakutana na pesa. Kama last time, last week, mtu amenitumia 2,000, si mtu kampuni. And it has happened, karibu 3 times, paka nikaenda paka Coop Bank, kuuliza. Hizi pesa ni za nani, naambiwa, hizo pesa tuwezi kutrace vile zimetu. But zimepitia hapa, kwenu. Anasifia sana. Zikakakaa kwa simu, zikakakaa kwa simu. Nikakula. Tena last week but one. Zingine zimekuja 2,000. Tena zinakaka hapo, zinakaka hapo. Upepo ukipiga piga. Baadaye nitakula. Kumbe Mungu ana njia nyingi za kutumia. Lakini kwanza, jua kama za mtu. Praise the Lord. I'm not saying utumiwe pesa by mistake. Unaona jina la mtu ndio hii kabisa imeandikwa hapa. Na namba yake iko hapa. Alafu naanza, Jesus, thank you, Jesus, Holy Spirit, thank you. Even pastor told, that's what I'm saying, hallelujah. I'm saying God can give you things. Now, utrace mwenyewe mpaka mwisho, ukose kumuona. Kumbe ni malaika alikuangushia. Praise the Lord. But if you see money is sent and there is a number, pigia huyo mtu pesa, rudishia yeye pesa zake. Ukikula wewe ni mwizi. Aya. The Holy Spirit. The third one is encounter what? The word. The Logos. I'm not talking the word, the flesh, Jesus. No, I'm talking about the word, the Logos. This one. And many Christians don't love the word. Hapendi kusoma neno, hapendi mahali neno linafundishwa. Wanapenda mahali kuna sarakasi. Sarakasi. Wakristo wengi wanapenda sarakasi. Ndio sababu hatuna misingi. Amen. Imeona jeneza kwa nyumba yako. Huyo ndio unataka kwenda kwake. Kwani mimi nikikwambia nimeona jeneza utaamini? Mbona sikwambii? Kwa sababu hiyo si ndio neno. Injili ni hii. Preach the word. Hallelujah. Preach the word. Ulikula mrenda yesterday. So, hata mimi mwenyewe ninajua nilikula mrenda. So, mbona anikumbusha? Praise the Lord. Sarakasi ni mingi sana kwa kanisa la Yesu. Na mimi sina time na sarakasi. I will preach the word as it is. Encounter the word. Praise the Lord. The final one I'm going to tell you because it will be a whole teaching. That one I will be able to tell you later. So the Bible says, if you must run that race, the rate of the faith, you must encounter those three plus the last one, which is very important and which I will be sharing on a lot. For now, if you must run this race, then you must run this race according to 2 Timothy chapter number 2, verse number 5. Please mark this, very important. 2 Timothy chapter number 5, chapter number 2, verse number 5. There is a particular way to run. Don't run aimlessly. Don't throw your blows like you are throwing in the space. Why did they win their battles? Because they had a way to run their battles. It says, everyone, read loud again. And also, if anyone competes in what? Athletics. He is not crowned unless he does what? Competes according to. According to. So when you run this race and you are number one, but you are not running according to the rules of the race, you can never be crowned. That's why when you read Matthew chapter 7, the Bible is very clear. Some will come to me and say, Lord, we preach in your name, and I will tell them, get away from me because I don't know you. Some will even say, we conducted miracles in your name. We led many to you, and I will tell them, get away from me, evil workers. Why? He is not what? Unless he competes according to what? The Bible said to rules. According to the rules. My brother, hii kitu si ya mchezo. Kuna waubiri wengi ambao wataubiri ili wapate sadaka. That is not one of my missions. Right now, I need money. But I'm telling you, I believe God will provide. I will not conduct a fundraising for any of my children to go to school. I believe God will provide. And I'll stand up here and tell you, he has done it. Waubiri wengi, wakutika res, wanakimbia, lakini kuna vitu wameficha. Wameficha. Biblia inasema, unless you compete according to the rules. It's not rules, the rules. Praise the Lord. What does that mean? It means God has established a pattern that if we are going to have sustainable results, we must follow the pattern that was established. Amen. I said hallelujah. When I talk about sustainable results, I mean results that are going to be here now, will be here tomorrow, and will be here after 5 years. We must go back to the pattern. What was the pattern of these results? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What was the pattern? Now Jeremiah says, in Jeremiah chapter 6, in verse number 16, very clear. Let's read that one, very key. We must go back to the ancient paths. Ile wokovu ya ujinga. Hallelujah. Ile wokovu ambayo watu wangetoa ushuhuda ya yale Mungu ametenda. Hiyo ndio wokovu, ile ulevi wa kitambo. Ndio sababu tumeanzisha witnessing, and we are going to witness. We will be on fire to tell about Jesus. Hallelujah. Because you want to compete according to the rules. And the Bible says, he who wins souls is what? Is wise. Hallelujah. Now it says, can we read together? Now you have life. Read again. Thus says the Lord. Stand where? In the ways. Stand in the ways. Hallelujah. Can you say in the name of Jesus? I stand in the ways. There is such a thing as the ways.
Na hizo njia zimesha pandwa, zimekuwa na nyasi sasa, hazionekani.
What one is ipitia zamani? Where people who come to church, unakuta mtu ataombi, anagrow. Hajui kuomba. Praise the Lord. Watu walikuwa nakaa katika maombi. Leo ukikuta watu kwa mkutano wa maombi una bahati. Tukitangaza sherehe ya kukula chapati na wali, watu watajaa. Tukitangaza mkutano wa maombi kama vile tunatangaza sasa Ijumaa, Sunday, Saturday, Friday, tuko hapa kwa maombi.
Ningesema tuko hapa kwa mchele, macho hata yule mwenye anataka kusinzia angeamka. Hallelujah.
Zile barabara za kitambo, the old drunkenness. Hallelujah. People used to love God more than everything. They will shout for Jesus. They will dance like, and it doesn't matter. Hata kama sina pesa, wangecheza kanisani. Walikuwa nampenda Mungu sana. Hiyo ulevi wa kitambo ndio natangaza ndio njia ambazo tutasimama kwazo.
He says stand. He doesn't say sit. In those ways people don't sit, they stand. Hallelujah.
Because for you to be in those ways, you need to be sober and alert. Hakuna mlevi katika hiyo barabara. Amen. Mtu wa kuona pornography hawezi patikana kwa hiyo barabara. Hiyo ni barabara ya watu wana stand. They are sober.
Are we together?
Are we together? Stand.
Where?
He says in the ways. In the ways. In the ways.
In other words, there are particular ways. There are several ways, but the particular ones. Kama ni kutoa, it's a way. Praise the Lord. Hutoi kwa sababu umebembelezwa, na hutoi kwa sababu umesukumwa.
Yani wewe, kuna kitu ndani yako ambacho najua mfereji wangu wa kupokea uko kwa kutoa.
That is a way. Are we together? I'll be showing you shortly. Because some people don't want that to be mentioned.
That is a way. That is a way.
You can choose to remain with it and only remain with it. But somehow, when you throw it on many waters, it seems to come back to you again. Sometimes God will tell you through it on many waters. Like now, the passion of preaching the gospel is at the heights. We want to preach the gospel. We don't want to be delayed by lack of funds when you have the funds. Amen? No, we don't want to be delayed by lack of funds. You know how many times I've been going to Mala, and Mala is 2,000 shillings every day. I go, come, I go. I give money for people to go. Like today, a team has gone there. And after this, I'm supposed to be going there with another car again. You think I will be poor? I will not be poor. I will not be poor! Because I did God's work. Stand in the ways. Could be the way of prayer. Could be the way of the word. Amen? Could be the way of singing and praise and worship, and you love it and you have to stay there. Could be the way of fellowship, where brethren are gathering together. You are willing to be there. You are willing to support one of the brothers who is needy. Which are the ways? Now, when you stand there, don't stand there and blinden your eyes. Do what? See. See. After you have seen, what? Ask. Because some of us have been born yesterday. We don't know those ways. What we found going on was Ororo, and we think salvation is all about Ororo. Excuse me. There is something more to that. Did you hear what I said? And I'm not attacking your private pastors, because you have some private pastors. Some of you who are here, but you are private pastors. Sunday uko hapa, Monday uko kwa private pastor. I'm talking about you who is a believer. Hallelujah. Simko now. You don't atumianga fungu la kumi, sindio huyo? Sitakosa kulisha neno. Lakini kuna kitu kinaitwa what? All the paths. Ay. These are patterns. They are like the patterns that we see in the book of 1 Kings chapter number 18, where the Bible says, and Elijah, hallelujah, he went up to the mountain and he put his head under the knees and he cried to the Lord. Old paths. Can you shout old paths? Say paths of analog. My God, can I hear some digital saying it? Paths of analog. Shout it if you are not a Gen Z. Paths of analog. Those paths, my brother. Hey, you stuck in the house of God with your hands lifted up. He's like, Mshindi, utakula leo? You are not hearing what you are being told. Hallelujah. The appetite of the stomach comes number two. There is another appetite that is stronger. Jesus said, my food is to do the will of him who sent me. When you locate what God sent you to do on earth, some things become secondary. Hallelujah. Some things become secondary. Let's go and watch football. Secondary. Let's go. Secondary. Including some of your appointments at Umeenda Airport. Kungoja mutu anakuletea tender. On a Sunday, ulirogwa na nani? Did you hear what I said? I will repeat that again because I'm talking. Put your microphone nyingine quickly, brother. Let me say it in two microphones. Okay, ndio hii hapa. Siku ya ibada, hata Wayahudi hawangelikula Jumamosi, wangelifunga biashara zao waende kuabudu Mungu. Hata leo Waislamu hawawezi kufanya biashara masaa yao ya kuabudu Mungu wao ikifika. Wewe unakumbuka Mungu wako siku uko mgonjwa. Umerogwa na nani? Leta microphone ya tatu na watu wasiki. Hallelujah. Kuna watu wasiki. Kuna watu wasiki. Biashara ni ya muda. Wewe ambaye ulirogwa, biashara ni ya muda. Haiwezi kukuweka milele. Hallelujah. kingine kinaitwa kupenda Mungu. Utashangaa siku ile ambayo umejipeana kwa Mungu ndio biashara zitaendelea vizuri sana. Lakini unakaa kwa kazi, hauzi kitu
lakini uko tu pale. Uko tu pale.
Watu wako mkutano,
uko tu pale.
Hauzi kitu, uko tu pale.
Bible talks about ancient paths. How we together, brethren? Hiyo injili haipendwi na watu, lakini ndio injili mimi naubiri. Hallelujah. Haipendwangi. Watu wanapenda kuvalishwa pampas. Utaenda wapi na pampas? Si usuguliwe kidonda kabisa kitoke uchafu, alafu kitapona haraka.
Turudi kwa ulevi wa kitambo. Ulevi wa kitambo, brother. You love God so much. Hauoni wanawake wako uchi.
Siliwaambia, another man of God was seated here. Conference inaendelea. Yeye akotupa simu. Akotupa simu. Sasa sijui kama roho mtaka kitu akamwambia share with Mshindi. Akamwambia, posto. Imagine a whole woman. This is not a girl. Putting on like this. Can you imagine a whole woman?
Jesus. Hey. Even in the church, you tell me, when this person is alone, what else is he doing? If that is in the church.
Kuna wengine lazima wapewe motivation. Motivation. Hey, sawa. Acha nisiende huko.
It talks about what? See and ask what? The old paths.
What again?
Where the good way is. And what? Walk in it.
Hallelujah.
Watoto wa Mungu, hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Running this race, there is a pattern of running it. It is called the old paths. We must go back there, begin running it like Paul ran it, like Peter ran it, like Abraham ran it. Then we shall win the battle.
Praise the Lord.
He says, after you find it, walk in it. Then what? Then what? Then what? You will find rest
for your souls. Now he doesn't talk about rest for your spirit, because it's romantic, that one. Rest for your soul is now what you are fighting for, looking for. With all power you are looking for is mapema asubuhi. Eh? Saa kumi ushaamka umeoga maji baridi. Eh? Mgu, pa, 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 pa. Unazimama kwa duka la muhindi kutoka na unaitwa pumbavu, jinga wewe. Na usemi kitu. Hapo unafurahia, unafanya, unauza. Wewe pumbavu, kuja hapa. Na mwenye anakuita pumbavu ni mtoto. Hiyo, you don't pick issues with it. Lakini kanisani ukikuja usisalimiwe na mtu, ukuji sande hiyo ingine. Wana sifa sana.
Siku ya kuja church, kama ya leo
unajivuta, hiyo ndio siku ya kuosha nguo, hiyo ndio siku mother-in-law anakuja kukutembelea. Mtu akikuuliza which day are you being found so that I can visit you,
Sunday. Bwana sifa. Can you imagine how much have you given to God in comparison to how much God has given you? 7 days He's asking you for hours only. Maana tuna ibada ya jioni. Anakuuliza, just give me 4 hours peke yake. Lakini hata hizo 4 hours, my brother,
choo peke yake umeenda mara 7. Tangu ulipokuja, kwani wewe ulikunywa vikombe ngapi ya chai? Simu hata sasa iko on. Inangojea nini? Pengine mteja anaweza akapiga simu.
Na uko church, uko kwa mlima wa maombi, lakini simu iko on. ananiambia those are old paths. Old paths where I saw people forget themselves in the presence of God. Wamejisahau kwa uwepo wa Mungu. Wako tu pale. Unaenda wapi? Naenda church. Kwani wewe ndiye pastor? Hapana, mimi ni mshirika. Lakini najua old paths. Hallelujah. Your words have no salt in it. Una maneno makali na umeokoka. Maneno machungu unapigia. Unaambia mtu neno ni kama umemlenga na mawe ya kutoka Nyanza. Eh? Neno lako moja linatoshana na liko zaidi ya mawe ya kutoka Nyanza. Nasema Nyanza kwa sababu Nyanza wanajua kurusha mawe. Sionei mtu. Mana siwe sana. Hallelujah. Every one of us is gifted. Ukienda Ukambani, tunajua kutengeneza tires za gari. Ukikuja Uluyani, tunajua kushika rungu na kukaa watchman. Yani kila mtu amepewa mahali pake. Sini kweli? Lakini pia tunajua kupika. Kupika chakula ya Mungu na pia kupika chakula ya ulimwengu. Tunajua hiyo. Now, I've lost. God has ordained a path for success. Hata utajiri wako mwenyewe, kuna pattern ya kuwa tajiri. Wewe kama mtoto wa Mungu. Watoto wa ulimwengu, kuna pattern yao. Wanaenda kwa mchawi, wanaambiwa leta kondoo, mwingine anaambiwa leta kuku, wanatoa. Lakini wewe mtoto wa Mungu, huwezi enda kwa mchawi, unakuja wapi? Kwa madhabahu ya Mungu. Kwa nini usijiulize? Pattern ya kufanikiwa kwa hii madhabahu ya Mungu ni gani? That is what is telling you, walk in those good ways. And you will find what? Rest for your souls. It is God's good pleasure to give every one of us rest. Now see, very fast as I finish. Two brothers born of the same mother and father. The very first sons in this world. That is who? Abel and Cain. In chapter number 4 of Genesis. The Bible says they came before God. And see, they opened them to give a sacrifice. Both. And walipofika kwa madhabahu, kila mtu akatoa. Wote wamecheza sasa ndio wakati wa kutoa sadaka. Wakachukua mikoba zao kila mtu. Biblia inasema namna gani? And in the process of time, read, it came to pass that Cain brought an offering. Cain did what? Brought an the fruit of the ground to the Lord. Brought an offering, please mark those words, of the fruit of the ground to the Lord. See the offering? See the kama ile umeleta leo? Yeah. Lakini ndugu yake Abel, twende. And Abel also brought brothers brought offerings. Two. Praise the Lord. But see, Abel also brought what? What? Shout it bigger than that. What? Of the first bones of the flock. What does that imply? Abel was saying, Mungu ni number moja. Amen. Yani in my life, God, Sir God, you are number one. Yani, umenibariki hivi, Sir God, we ni number one. Hakuna vile naweza vaa suti kabla ya kuvaa suti. Are you hearing what I'm saying? He said he brought what? Of the. Again, the. Don't forget that article there. The firstborns of his flock. Remember the other brother did what? He brought of the fruit of the ground. This is the difference between the two. And these kind of believers are both in the service today. One brought of the firstborn. worship. My God, it is worship deep inside. Mikono ziko juu, moyo umejipeana, amejitolea. Simu ikilia by mistake is a mistake. Hallelujah. Otherwise, wakati alistep kwa mlango wa church, alisema mambo ya simu, tutaonana baadaye. Hallelujah. Ukipiga simu, I'll call you back.
Praise the Lord.
Why? I have gone to the business of the one who holds my life. I'm here because of him. I can speak because of him. I am what I am because of him. I can do nothing on my own. It is Christ who has made me who I am. The Bible says he brought the firstborn of what? Of his flock. Brothers, this is how you. Tusome tena. Of what? Of his flock and
sasa wewe unataka kuniambia Mungu akiangalia hawa wawili hata kama wote ni watoto wake anaona wakiwa sawa? Hapana. Kuna mtoto mmoja Mungu anapendelea juu ya mwingine. Biblia inasema hana kipendeleo, lakini hapa kuna mtoto mmoja anakaa kuwa karibu na yeye kuliko mwingine.
Can somebody shout a better amen?
Amen.
Kuna mtoto mmoja anakaa anampenda sana.
Draw near me and I will draw near you.
Kuna mmoja mtoto na draw near him, so God is drawing near him.
So when it talks about the flock, it is talking about what? It is talking about blood.
In blood there is life. So when you bring a sacrifice of blood, one, you have established a covenant and you understand the pattern. This brother understood what God did with his father and mother in the garden when God slaughtered an animal na akawavalisha mavazi ya skin. Akatoa matawi, akatupa. This brother understood. Hallelujah. And of their fat. Tuendele. And the Lord what?
Please, someone read if you went to school. The Lord what?
Respected Abel and God respected Abel and his offering. Respected Abel.
So Mungu aliheshimu mtu na pia akaheshimu sadaka yake. Are we together?
Kwa sababu gani? Kuna mtu alitoa kulingana na pattern. Na kuna mtu alitoa kwa sababu watu wanatoa. Hata kama umetoa milioni moja, lakini hujaitoa kulingana na pattern, hakuna heshima kwako na hakuna heshima kwa matoleo yako. Kuna pattern. Everything has a pattern.
Hallelujah.
Everything has a pattern. So Biblia inasema God had respect for Abel and his offering, but not for Cain and his offering.
Continue a little more. But he did not respect what? Cain and and was angry and very angry and his countenance fell. Could that be the position of many of us here? Hungry. Mungu nimekuwa hapa miaka hii yote. Unanipita tu ukibariki wengine. Na mimi niko tu hapa.
What kind of offering did you bring him? How much of your time have you given God?
When it comes to worship,
wewe uko madoa doa ama uko full blast? Where are you standing? Can we count you as one of us? Can we count you as one of the children of God who are worshiping him in spirit and in truth? Kuna madoa doa mingi. He was angry and very angry and his countenance fell. Now listen to what God said. Very important.
This one should be my final word. Very important. And we'll pick it from there next time. Listen to what God says.
So what? Say to Cain, huh? Why are you
your neighbor, please don't be angry, tell them. God is concerned about your anger and is wondering, why are you angry? What has been done is justice. It is fair. It is fair that what you plant, you reap. So why do you want to reap what you didn't plant? I already painted my pattern of running this race. You have not run according to the pattern. Why do you want to reap what you didn't plant? So question, why are you angry? God didn't wait for an answer. He asked again, what? And why has what? Two very important questions. Why are you angry? And why has your countenance failed? Why are you discouraged? Why are you feeling that your legs are too heavy to come to the presence of God? Why do you feel that you must do something else? And then he helped him to answer the question. Let's go. He helped him to answer the question. Now read very loudly, very loudly. Read, everybody. If you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do, sin lies at the door and its desire is for you, but you should. My God. So, it has something about what you do. If you do well, if you do, will you not be accepted? So, for acceptance, there is something about what you do. What do you do? How are you doing what you are doing? Dear ones, hakuna kitu baba yetu hawezi kutupatia. Lakini kuna pattern ya kukimbia mbio zote za Mungu. Watoto wa Mungu, let us trace the patterns. Now, there is a very, very important scripture I want us to read in the book of Isaiah. Very important. But time cannot allow us. Kwa sababu ya yule mwenye alikuja saa sita na anastahili kuwa ashamaliza ibada. Wacha tumalizie. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Can somebody shout a big hallelujah? Well, you must rule over it. In other words, eat what you planted with comfort. Kama ulipanda mahindi, kula tu na usikie nimeshiba. Usitamani nini nyingine yapandwa? Muogo ama hii nyingine ya huku inapenda hii ya ukambani. Inaitwa nini kitu? Ukipanda mahindi, kula na ushibe na utosheke na hiyo mahindi yako. Usitamani nzuu yenye mtu alipanda. Na kama kuna mwenye alipanda mahindi na akapanda, usijiulize kwa nini wewe unapata mara mbili na mimi nimepata mara moja. What you plant, you reap. Amen. That is true about everything. What you plant, even if you don't reap it now, it's a matter of time. You are going to reap it. One day, utairip. Praise the Lord. If you do well, will you not be accepted? Brothers and sisters, when we come to worship God, fungua moyo wako wote. Hata usijali nani amesimama kando yako, hata kama ni boss. Wewe uko sasa mbele ya Mungu. Hallelujah. Usiangalie hata kama pasa na kuona ama kuoni. Ukikuja kanisani hapa na Mungu amekupatia kazi fulani ya kufanya, fanya na moyo wako wote. Siku moja utaripa. Kile unafanya leo is a matter of time. Tomorrow you will reap it. I request you stand up. Let me pray.